What's up, guys? Old Ed Mike here. Welcome to my reaction and review for Slaughter 2 Prevail's new single, Baba Yaga. Let's go. So, Slaughter 2 Prevail is... Oh, shit. My ears are upstairs. Here, let me just put these up for you guys so they don't... distract. There. Normal? Okay. So Slaughter to Prevail is one of those bands that everybody knows. Everybody knows Alex Terrible. They've been a band I've been following for quite a while. I don't so much listen to their music on a daily basis. That's just how I am with some deathcore. However, I love seeing them in concert, seeing them many times. In fact, when they were here in Dallas, Alex did the entire set in the pit. I have some pictures of that somewhere. Very sick, very awesome dude, awesome, talented members in the band. And of course, they put out Demolisher, and it was insane. So let's see if they can keep up with Demolisher with this new track, because everyone's going to be like, you know, they got to expect it now. So make sure you spin kick that subscribe button, helps me out a ton. Let's check out this track together. Also, check out my live streams that I do Friday night, 7 p.m. Central Standard Time. Really? Already? He's just right into the vocals. Love through the pain, nothing but fame. Loving the horror movie vibes they got going on here. Who's that? Jesus. Prosthetics here. Awesome. He's experimenting a little bit with, like, different vocal styles now. The talking and cleans. A little bit of, like, semi-cleans. That he, like, borrowed from his Slipknot cover. Fighting a bear. The production on this video is insane. Like, the quality is crisp. A little bit of an 808. Come on. Oh. Now they gotta do it. Now they gotta do it. That's pretty hard. The double bass. With the, I like the, they had like an industrial techno vibe behind it. Russian roulette. Very graphic video. Yeah, I'd say they brought it. That was more of like a standard deathcore, but with like some metalcore influences in there as well. It wasn't too extreme. Like the breakdown was had some borderline metalcore tendencies in there. I really appreciated them for that. Vocals, of course. As always, but he did kind of extend it a little bit there. He did the talking part into the screaming. I think that was him doing the cleans, because it kind of sounded like him, like I said in the video when he did his Slipknot cover. He has a real Corey Taylor-esque kind of voice. It's kind of very distinct. Drumming was great. Double bass was that syncopation during the breakdown, sick. Guitars, pretty standard, nothing negative there. Breakdown, some people probably won't compare very well to Demolisher, but it was a different kind of breakdown. Demolisher's breakdown was more of like a beatdown, fucking, you know, beat someone's ass, and this was like a, you know, kind of like a just a deathcore slash metalcore breakdown, where it's just kind of, it's kind of groovy, you know. Okay, very similar to Brand of Sacrifice. Felt a little bit of Brand of Sacrifice influence there, and then of course they had the little techno-y industrial techno part behind the breakdown as well. Kind of reminded me of Rammstein a little bit. Very interesting. Yeah, so good track. I think it's improved from their earlier stuff, in my opinion. This would be something I would probably listen to more on a more normal basis. Deathcore is just hard for me to sit down and listen to on a regular basis, unless I'm really, you know, pissed off. Great track. What would I give it? I'm gonna give it a 9 out of 10, especially for the with inclusion of the video. The video work was very good. Cinematography was great. Everything was crystal clear. The prosthetics they used, all that kind of stuff was on point, and had a cool little mixture of different scenes going on there. So 9 out of 10, definitely. Let me know what you guys thought. Looking forward to hearing some more new stuff. So yeah, other than that, spin kick that subscribe button, and again, come check us out on our live streams. We do 7 p.m. Central Standard Time Friday nights. And other than that, Old Head Mike signing off, reminding you, never too old for this.